All right, so we're just going to pretend I didn't just not upload for like 2 months. All right? All right. Let's just continue the series.
These things are horrifying, by the way. Chozo ghost, spectral entity, bioelectric field invulnerable to natural energies, x-ray scanning. There's a long one. But yeah, basically they shoot Kamehamehas at me, and we can only really hurt them with x-ray scanning. And I want to say super missiles? Super missile? You know, when in doubt, assume a super missile will do the job. But yeah, sorry it's been so long since the last upload, but I waited until we got somewhere, like, to progress to actually start the recording, though. But yeah, there was a lot going on. Don't need to go into it really right now, but we're back. We're not stopping until we finish this game. Oh, Jesus Christ! You think all the Chozo could roll up into a ball? Because they have a lot of ball abilities here. All right, we are up here now. Oh, that's the ice beam. There it is. Just like that. Just like that, we got the ice beam. Ice beam is our primary method for dealing with the titular Metroids, by the way. 40 years of backtracking later, we're actually in a new room. I can't believe it. Oh, whoa, what are you?
Hunter Metroid. I forgot that there were other kinds.
No. Chill. Calm your shit. You're still a Metroid, goddammit. So they're making us do a little water bit right now to make us really, really want the gravity suit. Thankfully, I don't think there's that much of forced water BS before we get it. Boys, it's just right here in this alcove, bro. I didn't even try. There was no boss fight, no anything. It was just there. But either way, we got it now, which means we can go to the sunken frigate Orpheum. And also, gravity suit, sick looking. I wonder if they changed it in the remaster, actually. I guess we're gonna find out. It looks pretty much the same. A little more blue. Like, it's so interesting just how they reuse the same area and made such a cool level out of it. Like, the design is interesting. It's like the most serene song in the game for an area that, without the gravity suit, A, I don't remember if it's even possible to finish it. Oh, that guy's dead. And B, is incredibly frustrating to get back out of if you get, like, halfway in and realize you need it. So, you know, at least the thermal visor, like, looks cool. Because if it looked, like, dumb to do all this, I'd be more upset we're missing out on some of this, like, awesome scenery. The thermal visor just makes it look incredible. Like, it's such a vibe, dude. It's such a good vibe. I'm big on vibes, boys. One thing I gotta learn, I'm huge on vibes. When I'm trying to decide where I want to go, like, drink in the night or something, or go out to eat, if the vibe is crap, I'm not interested. The vibe needs to be there, the food needs to be good. And then I'm happy. All right, boys, we made it. The Phazon Mines, the penultimate area of the game, home of the Omega Pirate, and at least 2 billion Metroids. We're probably gonna be here a while, but we'll keep the video. We'll keep the video short. What are they gonna throw at me now? Oh, the Wave Troopers. I forgot about these guys. That's right, they made some adjustments. Now they can only be killed with certain beams, which I like that. It forces you to use something you're not comfortable with or just mix it up a little bit. Better for combat in general. Plus, I think these guys are the actual toughest space pirates. There's also the ones that just like are weak to the power beam, plasma beam, etc. But these dudes don't mess around, man. I remember this room. We're gonna be here a while, boys. I'm not a puzzle man, people. This might take 120 years. We might have to use a SpongeBob time card. In fact, we probably have already done it. I think this is where we fight our first alpha pirate. I think that's what they're called. I have no super missiles too, which basically means it's much more difficult than it needs to be. He's an alpha pirate, an enhanced pirate. What's his name? Phazon pirate? What is it? Elite pirate. God damn it. Come on, big guy. I like his big ass mounted cannon on his back. So he's really not that tough. Just one nice ice beam shot to the face was all it took. Oh, and he's an ice pirate. You shouldn't have. These ice pirates are the funniest enemies, dude. They're specifically designed to be weak to ice. Like, why would they decide that? Why would they just be like, okay, this is my one weakness. The one that makes me stop moving altogether. Okay, what the hell is this? Oh, it's the power bomb. That's where we get the power bomb. Nice. Very nice.
Impressive. Very nice.
So power bombs are, without question, the most powerful thing in this game. There's a lot of space pirates in this room. A lot of Metroids. Oh, this is where the Metroids get released. We're going to let them out. We're going to let them out, boys. This is it. The Metroids are going to go attack the space pirates for me, I hope. Please? Yeah, let's go. He's doing it. He's doing the thing I told you. They attacked them. Metroids, do what you're trained to do. No, not me. Metroid killed that guy for me. Okay, we're good. That was horrifying.
But see, I told you they could attack them like 2 months ago.
I actually have to backtrack.
All right, boys, time to cut the recording until we get what we need.
2 hours later.
After scouring the entire Phazon mines for about 15 minutes for a single power bomb to open this door, we got this. Finally, some progress. We're getting the grapple beam, baby. We do still need to backtrack and get the x-ray visor. I thought it'd be this long thing, but it was like a 30-second detour. Boom, x-ray visor. We can now see some mysterious invisible platforms. Let's head right back where we just were. Okay, we finally made it back to the Metroid quarantine. That is an awful lot of them. You guys are just gonna not notice me, right? That'd be perfect. Let me tell you guys how stupid this last bit of backtracking was. There's just some invisible platforms that you physically cannot get to without a little bit of backtracking. Don't get me wrong, it's not so bad. The way back is super fast and, like, relatively tame. Please. Okay. And, like, relatively quick. But they could just put the x-ray visor in the Phazon mines, right? I don't have the... Are you kidding me? Are you... I don't have the plasma beam. What have you done, game? Oh, no. Now what do I have to go? Oh, no. All right. I thought we were done backtracking, but I must have forgotten about the plasma beams, so...
6 months later.
Okay, so now we're all the way back in Magmoor, where it wants us to do something. I guess, oh yeah, sure, why not? And then I think it's just do this until, and I'm pretty sure a door opens. There's more to it than I thought. There's a little more to it than I thought. I was like, oh yeah, a door's gonna open and then we'll just, no, we, whole ass spider ball track. I can't wait. Let's do it. I actually don't mind the spider ball sections. I just wish I didn't have to go through the same area several times to get to it. And then we have to drop carefully. Oh, dude, if I missed that and had to climb all the way back up, I think that would have been the end of the playthrough. Oh my god, what if I didn't have a power bomb? No, no! Okay, this time for sure. This time for sure. Plasma beam? Plasma beam, baby. Plasma beam, my darling. You put me through hell, you son of a bitch. Finally, we have the last beam. The most powerful beam in the game. Finally, we can go back and deal with that last menace. I should go unlock a couple other things, but I'll get them later. Let's head right back. All right. We finally, after all that, made it to the Omega Pirate, dude. I couldn't remember if we had to do something before we fight him or if we just fight him. But this is it. Next major boss is taking down a peg. Oh, we got him. Let's go. That was a tight one, dude. He put up a fight. Omega Pirate was out for blood, and Samson doesn't get out of the way, dude. Like, what was her plan here? She should be dead, but by, you know, mysterious circumstances, well, I'll let the cutscene explain it for me. We get the sickest suit in Metroid history. The Phazon suit, dude. Look at this. She's a beast. She got the aura. The Phazon suit is awesome. I love it so much. And my only complaint about the Phazon suit is it just basically means we only have the gravity suit for very little time. All right, we're back where it all began at the Talon 4 overworld. All we have left to do is the worst part of the game by far, the artifact quest, which is literally just a backtracking quest to find a bunch of MacGuffins to open a door to the final boss. I will be doing all this off camera, and then we're going to come back and kick the final boss's ass. So I will see you guys then in a little bit. It'll be instant for you guys, but for me it'll be like probably a day. So see you then.
7 months later.
All right, everybody, it's time.
I went and did the whole artifact hunt off camera, which is that side quest that everybody basically dreads, where you go back to previous areas to find a MacGuffin that's hidden with a very vague hint. No shame, I used to guide. I remember where a few of them were, but definitely not all of them. And I was not in the mood to just search aimlessly. So we used the guide. Anywho, that took me about an hour. It's not as bad as I remember, but I still wish it wasn't in the game, or at least that it wasn't mandatory. Like, if they want to do that, that's right, we didn't even walk in here yet, but if they want to do that, they should make it optional and give you something really cool as a reward, like a new, like, ultra-powerful beam or something game-breaking, because that's like a completionist type of thing that they're forcing you to do, which, you know, it's Metroid Prime 1. This game came out in 2002. This game is 20 years old, 21 years old even. That's crazy. If there's one thing I did horribly on this playthrough, by the way, if there's one thing I did absolutely horribly, missiles. I'm pretty good at energy tanks, but missiles, there's like 200 missiles in this game. I only have 50. Like, I missed a lot. Anywho, that's the final artifact, by the way. That's why there was one missing in my logbook a second ago. But we've got them all now. Got the whole collection, and we're where we need to be to use them, so that's going to trigger a cutscene. Dude, the Phazon suit is so sick. I love it so much. I had to do the artifact hunt off camera. Nothing interesting happened. There's a couple fights. I fought another elite pirate. I did a couple puzzles, but it was just nothing that I really felt the need to show. The artifacts are supposed to open the temple, and then Ridley's like, nah, bro. Did you forget about me, bro? I'm still too big for Smash. They have to use a mini mushroom on me to get me in. Look how huge I am. So Ridley, honestly, if you ask me, his easiest fight. I remember in Nintendo Power, I don't know why this always stuck out in my head, but Nintendo Power like had a hardest bosses poll way back when this game came out, and Metal Ridley topped it as the hardest boss on GameCube at the time. And that's crazy, man. I did also get a couple cool things. Check this out. Basically, we got the Wave Bus, which is basically a Ghostbusters proton pack, basically. It's pretty badass. It's usually the easiest way to kill him. I just don't have the missiles to really use it properly. I will say the Metroid Prime 3 version, I do want to play Metroid Prime 2 and 3, by the way. It's just I'm confident Nintendo's going to remaster both of them. But the Metroid Prime 3 Ridley theme and the Smash versions are insane, dude. I don't know, this is a cool boss fight, but it's super easy. You know, if I die to him just because I said that, by the way, I'll have earned it. Oh, there he is. Hey, big guy. I wish that you would give me some more missiles so I could wave buster you again. That'd be cool. Dude, I was so happy when he finally got added to Smash. I was like, dude, more Metroid love, please. Burn his wings, burn his wings. I could talk about Metroid 2 Remake spoilers, right? Samus Returns, the Mercury Steam one. Is the fight with Ridley at the end of that game not the sickest fight that this character has ever had? That is, without a doubt, the best boss fight Ridley has ever had. But it is funny, though, how Ridley always seems to get rebuilt, put back together, cloned. Like, you can't get rid of this dude. Like, if a Metroid 6 comes along, he's not going nowhere. I think Dread might be my favorite Metroid game. Like, it's just so good. It's challenging. It feels badass. And I think Prime is a close second. This replay has still reminded me just how much I love Prime, despite my issues with its backtracking. Really good boss fight, set pieces, the vibe is unlike any— oh, here's where we shoot him in the face. That's how we damage him now. Like, the vibes, though, the areas, the music is incredible. But you guys see what I mean, though. I just wish there was more challenge. The challenge in Metroid Prime is more just from figuring out where to go than the actual combat, honestly. And I'm okay with that, too. That's one of the reasons I love this game so much. But I feel like the combat should be a little more challenging. Even though, you know, the rule of Metroid, it gets easier as you play. Like, because Samus gets so much more powerful, the game is at its hardest in the beginning, which is the case in every Metroid game. Like, by the end of it, you're like a walking ball of death by the end of every other Metroid game. But, dude, they should have added... Maybe they did, honestly, and I just don't know. But they should add, like, in the remaster specifically, of like a crazy hard mode. Like, put like a fusion mode in every game, or a dread mode, or some— oh, excuse me, sir. But they definitely should have put a super hard difficulty in every game. No matter how sick the fight still is, like, difficult or not, this is such a cool fight. And I actually prefer the Meta Ridley fight to the final boss, personally. However, the final boss has one thing on Meta Ridley. which we'll see when we get there, which if you saw my previous playthrough of this game, you'll know. He's getting some shots on me, though, to be fair. Oh, we hit him out of it. It's all about the timing, boys. Let me just light him up with the plasma beam. I feel like if he did just a little more damage, this fight could be dicey, because he's hitting me. But there's just, like, no stakes. It's not finishing me off. But, all right, we got him. He's dead. Bye-bye, Meta Ridley. We'll see you in Metroid Prime 3. Oh, I forgot this happened. Yeah, the Chozo just like, yeah, Samus butter him up for us. And then it's just, how does he survive this? Because this game takes place between Super Metroid and Fusion, so I don't know. But he appears again. He's definitely back one more time before the end of the, before Dread. Heading into the crater, heading into the northern crater where Sephiroth awaits us. I was joking, it's the impact crater, but it's, the joke is there. It's not just me. All right, the impact crater is not the biggest area. I originally was gonna separate the finale into its own video, but decided against it just because this area is pretty much just like a short walk to the final boss and just dodging some Metroids. Now don't get me wrong, this place is horrifying and I could still see Sephiroth living here, I could. Because there's Metroids just everywhere. And these are talent, and these are Phazon Metroids. Oh, please God. Yeah, these are Fission Metroids. They split into two. And the easiest way to deal with these guys is just powerbomb them. It's just, if you have the powerbomb, just use it. It saves you a lot of headache. That right there, that's our target, boys. Let's do it. Final boss time. Now, there's two phases. The first phase is actually a pretty challenging fight. The second phase is just badass. But it's still fun. But dude, the Phazon suit, bro. That's it, that's him. That's Metroid Prime. Basically a hyper-evolved, super crazy Metroid. He looks more like a standard Metroid than like the big boys evolve into. But I've done this fight many times. And look, he's got eggs for all the Metroids. He's basically a Metroid King. We've seen the Metroid Queen before. All right, but even still, This dude's not that tough, because he just changes color. You just aim whatever color... Oh god, I pressed the wrong button. You just aim whatever color he changes into, and you just kind of blast him. So he's power bomb color. Excuse me, he's power beam color. You super missile him. And then we gotta go hide, because he's gonna come over here. He's not coming over here. We're not at that point yet. See, now that he's wave beam colored, we need to go up here and wave buster him. Which... Would be great if I had more missiles. This is just, it just burnt a lot of missiles. And this fight's gonna be a lot harder without missiles now. I think I love Samus just running after him though. I gotta use that in the thumbnail, just Samus running herself somehow. There's gotta be something there. Metroid Ridley was definitely what feels like the real challenge here. Because Metroid Prime has a ton of health, and he just burrows deeper and deeper, which I think is cool. But it feels more cinematic than actually challenging. We're gonna flamethrower him. Like, the one thing I really do like about this fight, it does make you use, like, almost everything you've learned. Like, every mechanic you have, like, available to you. Every weapon you're using. Which is good, because most bosses in this game, pretty much just use the strongest weapon you have at the time. And that's it. And the weapons do just get stronger as you go. Like, the ice beam is stronger than the wave beam. The plasma beam is stronger than both of them, you know? Like, there's no reason to use anything else besides the plasma beam. Besides to open doors after a certain point in the game. So I'm glad this fight makes you use everything that you've like acquired. Hey, you don't like that, do you? You don't like your Ghostbuster Proton Pack second super missile? Oh, big boy's dead. Easiest fight of my life. Dude, Metroid Prime took me like 15 minutes. Metroid Prime? Like, 5. But alright, time to get in there. Samus is just like, oh, that was easy. It ain't dead yet, though. And you know how Samus is with Metroids. If it has the word Metroid in its name, it has to die. This room looks different. But there's the real Metroid Prime. This one also looks a lot like a standard, like, ungrown Metroid. I guess that's what it is. I guess it is just like a male Metroid, huh? Scan it. What are these things? Alright, so to beat this Metroid Prime, we need to stand in a Phazon goop that it creates. Until then, we can't do a thing to it. But it looks sick. I love how good it looks in this remake. It looks awesome. So real talk, I don't know why he would excrete this goop. The first fight makes you shuffle between like all of your gear. While this one makes you shuffle through all your visors. Where'd he go? Where are you, big guy? There he is. And then you get the hyper beam by standing in his Phazon goop, and you just light this dude up, bro. Oh, there we go. Look how sick the hyper beam looks. You just, like, unload on him, dude. But I like that. I like how the first phase makes you cycle between your beams, second phase makes you cycle between your visors. You get to use everything. Everything the game has taught you. And that's just good boss design. Like, oh my god. Light him up. Light him up. And the hyper beam in 3, when you get, like, permanent access to it, it's just not the same. It doesn't hit as hard. Like, it just... It has a feeling in this game that was never matched. Oh, there you are. Finish him off? Not yet. Not yet. One more round. Finish him off. Finish it off. Kill it. It's still alive. No, it's not alive. All right, we did it. Fight's over. We won. Oh, that was a tough one. This was a fight I remember being easier, actually, which is kind of funny. It almost looks like an X-Parasite. Like the membrane type of thing that you absorb the power-ups from, the end, like Infusion. It almost looks kind of like that. Dude, Metroid Prime Infusion released on the same day, by the way. Isn't that crazy? That would never happen nowadays. But yeah, it took the Phazon suit, which is how Dark Samus gets created, by the way. Dark Samus is Metroid Prime. Like, that's why it's still the name of the series. But yeah, well, this is a Metroid game, by the way. We have to escape. We gotta run away. So we're gonna do that. I could have sworn there was an escape sequence. I guess there was one in the frigate Orpheum, but oh, that's opposed, dude. Faith in Samus has been well rewarded. And this narrator, dude. A new star shines in the universe. I forgot. Did I earn enough things for it to show us Samus's face? What future? If not, we gotta go look up what Samus's face looks like in this game. But that's it. Metroid Prime. We beat it again. Still one of the goats. The backtracking I played myself on because I kept thinking I had everything I needed that I didn't, but I still love this game to death, so hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm sorry it took me so long to finish it. There's been a lot going on. My community posts went into that if you're curious, but either way, guys, it's good to be back. Content will be much more consistent real soon, starting with this, and next up is Zelda Breath of the Wild. We're going to do a nice playthrough of that, just a casual, chill one. Until Tears of the Kingdom comes out. So if you're not subscribed, subscribe for that. It will be going up probably the week after this. So guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.